Biometric data. All right. Confirm. She looks different, though. Is she puking? Ew. Jackie Wells.
V, you there?
I didn't answer.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm here.
You all right?
Fine. I just needed a breather.
Sounded like you blew your guts airlock.
Sorry about that, man.
Yeah, I barfed. It's just stress.
Esa chamba te va a matar.
What? Now, I think now I can't use the keys, but I can... Yeah, that goes up and down. But can I also... Oh, no, I can't.
Hey,
oh.
You all there, V?
This looks around during dialogue. I was going to pick it with the mouse. It's like an I and K, because I changed my stuff around. You can't do that right now. What's it saying I can't do?
Talk to me, Chumba.
Chumba. Everyone's a critic. F?
Yeah. Maybe I should have gotten a safe one. Like you did.
Hey, at least I always know who's shooting at me. Sometimes even why. Anyway, what's going on?
Is there a problem?
Is there a problem? We had a leak. My boss called, dragged me in because we had to intervene. Everyone at Night City HQ is on edge.
But no way you're fucked, right? You're the one who fixes other people's shit.
Jackie, if you work in Arasaka counter intel, you're always fucked.
Yeah, don't worry about me.
Don't worry about me. I'll manage on my own.
Buena suerte.
Okay, first time in Night City, pay close attention to tutorials to learn more about the basic mechanics of the game. Or if you're already an experienced edge runner, feel free to disable hints. No, I am not. Go to the database at any time during the game to access tutorials as well as read up on the most important topics. Cyberpunk 2077. Who knows what you might find? Pending notifications from Quantified Satori, Pharma Report. Neuro boost. Well, it goes out. Okay. Can I save here? The corporate rat manual save. All right. So I apologize for the issue with the audio that happens now and then.
Are you all right?
What's up? Jenkins is waiting for you in his office. I can't talk to these people. Alright, we're going out. It took me a while to get used to the F control. Active job objectives are marked with... Is this... What's with the stripes going? It's really distracting. Graphics? Field of view. 90. Is it 90 standard? 95? Does that look better? It was looking really constricted to me. Let me know if you guys are okay with 90 field of view.
No, it's all leaked.
Arasaka security forces.
There's a small leak. Mass riots. A few hours later, we lose lunar base license. Have they voted already? They're about to.
An Arasaka
That's Jenkins'
investigation
problem.
Eliminates
if he fails to handle it,
Janeiro,
it'll cost the company
ending
millions.
A string of attacks and executing those responsible. 2076.
Mm-hmm. Wow. I want that. A family of empire. New shard. Read message. The legacy of Arasaka needs no introduction. The Arasaka Corporation is one of the world's most powerful, with offices located in every major metropolis across the globe. Hope I'm saying that right. Arasaka? For years, it has been behind the proverbial wheel of our planet's economy and society. The history of Arasaka in Night City is deserving of its own article, but suffice to say, the media industry in our city follows the family behind the megacorp as closely as they do share prices. The story of the Arasaka family is one of empire, a true dynasty under the rule of patriarch Saburo Arasaka. Rumors of the great Saburo's retirement and cession of company control, as well as his closely guarded secrets to his daughter, Hanako? It's hard for me to tell the A's and the O's here. Yorinobu have come and passed in recent years, but has the time come when such rumors may finally contain a grain of truth? Our sources report that Yorinobu Arasaka is currently in Night City, but not for a social call. And yet, if Yorinobu is strategizing a move for the throne, what of Hanako? Experts who follow the family closely unanimously agree that, due to ideological differences between Saburo and Yorinobu, Hanako will likely cement herself as the one true heir to the immense fortune and power of the Arasaka family. However, reality is hardly ever so predictable. Familial power dynamics can shift in an instant. For example, what would happen if Hanako fell from favor at a time when Yorinobu had his father's ear, and scenario might cause such a fall? No family is without its secrets, and the Arasakas are no exception. After all, what appears first as heaven appears second as hell. Japanese proverb. Is that true? Is that a real proverb? So we can't just, like, talk to everybody.
You think Japan will find out?
I wish we could.
About what?
About Frankfurt. I mean, it's a small leak, but still.
Japan already knows.
Where'd you hear this?
Assume Japan knows everything. It's safest that way.
Okay, so I see a little mini-map here. I don't know what that means in the bottom left. A connection? Is that stocks I see scrolling across the bottom right? Well, of course, before I go to my destination, I'm gonna go everywhere.
No, not till after dinner, probably. I'll let you know when I have a better idea. Yep, me too. Bye.
I look so much cooler than all these people. What really happened in Arasaka Tower? If Militech was behind the assault on Arasaka Tower in 2023, and if there's actual evidence to support that, then why didn't Arasaka return the favor and nuke Militech? By now, there's no doubt the bomb was manufactured by Militech, but that doesn't mean they detonated it. I confess, I'm not a huge fan of the popular theory that Johnny Silverhand, I know who he is, the controversial rocker boy, was behind the whole thing. In fact, I'm not really a Silverhand fan, period. Silverhand was a poser and a blowhard. Dissed. Not someone who would actually follow through on his grandiose bluffs. Full disclosure, I just think Silverhand... Don't think Silverhand would have the balls to pull off something like that. Let's think this through. Who hates corporations the most? Nomads, obviously. Remember that mass market BD called Badlands Raid from the 20s about a band of nomads that attack a Militech convoy? Well, guess when it premiered? That's right, on the night of the attack. Coincidence? I think not. Yes, there's a Silverhand cameo in there somewhere. But that's just a marketing ploy. A BD scrolled by a bunch of cactus huggers. Sounds painful. Wouldn't sell for an any without a recognizable face. But I'm more intrigued by the main actress. How is it she didn't star in any other production besides Badlands Raids, despite Badlands Raids' huge sales? Where was she during the attack? What's BD? I don't know what BD is. Mass market BD. I don't know. Alright, can we go in here? Probably not. Oh, it's locked. Where do you think you're going? Leeroy Jenkins. We're just gonna look around here first. What is that?
They're transferring them out of Frankfurt now to emergency centers. Just got the latest report from Basel.
I heard there's two dead.
Three. They took out another Militech assassin near the border.
What are you? Whatever you are cool looking. I can jump in you and shoot the hell out of people. I love it.
Why is this taking so long?
It's because of what happened in Europe.
I heard. Data leak in Frankfurt. Ugh, half-brain management we're gonna pay for in sweat.
I can talk to him.
Goodbye.
Or not. I can't exit. I'm not going out. All right. Now I got.
All Class A homes are requested to immediately report for their monthly review.
I didn't miss anything. Wait. Euro dollars. I love those Euro dollars. Thank you very much. Big five employers in Night City. Let's read about them. It's that time of year again. We present our list of the biggest and best corps to work for in Night City. Who offers paid vacation? Who pays for employees' trauma team insurance policies? Who provides discounts for daycare and child bodyguard services? Have a look at our rankings below. 1. Arasaka, coming in again this year at our number 1 spot, the Japanese Zaibatsu juggernaut. Employees can expect to be fit with the latest in cyberware technology with a loyalty obligation of only 20 years. You can't leave them for 20 years. And that's a good thing. In this case, a good duration. 2. Militech. The American arms giant provides its employees with up to 50% discounts on all Militech weapons. With a deal that good, you'd be able to put a Mark 31 heavy machine gun under the Christmas tree for everyone in the family. Oh, little Bobby will love that. 3. Biotechnica. Our 2077 bronze medal goes to Biotechnica, who offers up to 6, yes, 6 paid vacation days a year. Oh my god. That's not that great. 4. Kang Tao. China's largest tech and arms manufacturer treats employees to a gold membership with Trauma Team. Never spend a single minute of your 50-year loyalty pledge worrying about paying for health coverage. I hope you start working for them young, because damn. 5. Night Corp. While this hometown product can't compete with the biggest international players in terms of budget or ambition, they certainly know how to spoil their staff. Night Corps snuck into our Big Five after a recent announcement to reduce the mandatory work week to just 80 hours. Oh, God. They are a must apply for all you family-focused folks out there. Well, if you get weekends off, at least you have weekends off. Because 80 hours is, yeah. You come home and sleep and then go right back there. Assuming they're 16-hour days, I don't know. So this isn't anything. I'm wearing heels. Oh. That's cool.
Arasaka security forces prevent mass riots in San Francisco.
Hi.
Don't touch me.
2074.
I like what you said,
Bennett. Jesus, the Eurasian markets are going wild. Not to mention London, Zurich, Warsaw.
Yep. It's disintegrating.
Yep.
Everyone's reacting to this leak. Markets down, arms transport stalled, ops in retreat, months of work out the window.
Counter intel's in the grinder.
Hmm. Looks like things have been better. Oops, I'm on the table. Onboarding, Night City Branch. This guide is intended for all Arasaka agents beginning work in Night City. Please follow the local code of conduct as it may differ from other Arasaka locations. You must possess the largest corporate issue firmware at all times when inside Arasaka Tower. Arasaka. Consider this your primary form of identification. All agents are required to issue schedule progress reports to the appropriate senior officers. All lead officers are responsible for reporting to the operations manager. In the event of operational crisis, all agents are required to report to Arasaka Tower. Exemptions can be issued to active field agents involved in highly classified operations. All operational units in Night City fall under the oversight of the Director of Special Operations, Director Abernathy. Mm. Director Abernathy. I am definitely looking around for everything and anything. And this just goes back here, yeah.
2067. An Arasaka bodyguard shields the enemy. 2071.
So I just want to make sure I haven't missed any of these, like, pamphlets or whatever they have, little history documents. I think I've got all the ones on this side. So I'm assuming we can't go in these.
How will Arasaka shine
blocked.
In 2077? That depends on you.
Oh, and depend on me if I were you. Upstairs. It says my cortisol level is elevated. Well, this goes back down. All these things are locked. Okay. And we came from there, so that's it. I'm guessing these we can't go up. Just checking. Parking. If an attribute requirement appears in red, it means your attribute level is not high enough to perform the function.
Okay.
Oh my god. He walked through me. As a young man. Hello?
Christ, V, you were supposed to be here an hour ago.
That's all? Got held up.
Got held up, but I'll be right there.
Fucking Frankfurt. That Abernathy bitch will probably dump it in our laps. Hanging up. I'll be in my office. You hurry up.
So just like the first Mass Effect, we've got a Jenkins. This is obviously a reference to our buddy Leeroy.
Militech hit three of ours. Now we're evacuating the rest of our facilities in that part of Europe.
What's the status of the three?
They're dead. Once everyone else is safe, we'll issue a statement to the media.
Saying what?
A tragic accident during routine security system maintenance would be my bet.
The Pearl, the Alps. Where's our inventory? Ah, there. Okay, we've got backpack and cyberware. Okay, I'm wearing this. V's office blazer. 5.9 armor. A corporate uniform, designer level quality, sure, but a uniform nonetheless. That's cute, actually. Okay. And then, okay, back, got it. Arasaka's dress code is your dress code. Office slacks. Office pumps. Forget about suits. True success is measured by one's shoes. Consumables. Backpack. Common item components. We got zero of this stuff. Uncommon, rare, upgrade, rare item. Epic. Legendary. Wow. Uncommon, rare, upgrade. Cool. All items? Okay. This means because it's on, I have more. Okay. Alright, so that reduces movement speed by 10% and weapon accuracy by 50%. Quality doesn't cut corners, so I don't see if there's any upside to using that. And then cyberware, we don't have anything yet. Oh, wow. Circulatory system, immune system, nervous system, I don't even know what that is. Integumentary system? Ocular system, yeah, frontal cortex, operating system, skeleton, hands, arms, legs. Wait, so it highlights where you are. Operating system, so. Yeah, I'm not sure what that is. Your skin? Look like your outside skin or something. It looks like there's a little brain demon in there. Look at that. Okay. That is interesting. We got weapons. Yeah. Journal. Sometimes I wonder what it's like to work for Arasaka, you know? The way I figure it, it's like playing Russian roulette for a million eddies. Give it a spin, pull the trigger, you hear it click, you strike it rich. If you don't, well, the mess is someone else's problem. Oh, wow. Side job. Biz that won't make any major headlines, favors, straightforward tasks and choice, chance encounters, danger very high. Okay, we can zoom it all around. I like that. I'm not doing that now, am I? Undiscovered. Who knows what you might find? It's all very high. So this is all of Night City here? Oh. What the hell happened? I must have clicked outside of the glen. North side, Kabuki, Little China, Arasaka waterfront. Unknown island. Japantown. North Oak. Charter Hill. That's all these districts. Vista del Rey. Arroyo. The Glen. Well Springs. Rancho Coronado. West Wind Estate. Coast View. Where's the place that guy was talking about in the radio transmission? I don't see it. Maybe it's a sub-district of one of these. It's in Japantown. Alright. Stats. Okay. Crit damage, 106. That's good, isn't it? Doesn't that look good? Armor health. Wow. All these stats, my god. Someone did say it was a little overwhelming, all the different stats and skills and such. Effective damage per second. Yeah, I'm crappy except for crit damage. Well, I guess because I don't have a weapon. So. Okay, there's all my core stats. Crafting, no mind. What's skip time? Cannot skip time right now. Oh, like waiting? Makes sense. Database. Oh god. There's that same thing again. Jackie Wells. Okay, so this is tutorial stuff. Seeing surrounding areas. This stuff. Vehicles? Is this all vehicles? What if I click that? World. Alright, I'm probably going to have an episode where I just read all about the vehicles in world. But we got two characters right now. Us, we know. Jackie Wells is a proud son of Hayward and an even prouder son of Mama Wells. Jackie's stubborn. When he wants something, he won't stop or shut up about it until he gets his hands on it. Jackie always wanted a lot out of life, maybe too much. As a teenager, he joined the Valentinos gang, but realizing how much he was capable of, he quit. For years, he hustled through the unforgiving world of merc work, because you need more than a go-getter attitude to sit at the big boy's table. You need street cred. Jackie's life goal has always been to become a legend at the afterlife and make a heap of eddies along the way. Night City. Should I read about this stuff? The City of Dreams was founded in the 1990s by visionary industrialist Richard Knight. Oh, really? So it was Night City after him. Here I thought it was just because, you know, nighttime is cool. I don't know. The city never sleeps. When the world of late 20th century plunged into chaos, Knight envisioned a modern metropolis free from crime, poverty, and corruption. Corporate partners Arasaka, EBM, and Petrochem helped him realize this vision, investing in the foundation of what would become the free city of Night City. The city would develop into a haven for young idealists and a beacon for others who sought to fulfill their own dreams. And although Richard Knight fell to assassins and many new generations seeking fame, fortune, and freedom have suffered their own set of setbacks, the city's legendary status endures today. Night City has it all, from the monumental skyscrapers of industry-leading megacorporations to the luxury villas of world-renowned stars to the lawless neighborhoods where war is waged every day. You will stumble across mercenaries, gangs, and famous rockers, but also junkies, bums, and even cyber psychos. I heard about that on the radio broadcast, cyber psycho crime spree or something. You will stand in the shadows of colossal mega buildings and get lost in the maze of streets, alleys, and markets. You will make your dreams come true or die trying. Alright, so city center. Just read these two and we'll continue. If you stand in the middle of Corpo Plaza and observe what's around you, all the breathtaking mega buildings, office blocks, bars, clubs, architectural wonders, and dazzling neon signs, it's hard to believe that only a few decades ago, the area looked like a smoldering battlefield in the aftermath of the Fourth Corporate War. There were three other corporate wars. And a nuclear attack on Arasaka Tower. As anyone with a pair of optics can see, City Center was fully rebuilt, surpassing even its former glory with more modern and cutting-edge architecture. It serves one purpose, and one purpose only, to flaunt the city's economic power and prove that Night City is freer than ever before. And then Corpo Plaza, which is where we are now, I think. Rebuilt after the Fourth Corporate War, Corpo Plaza is one of the most iconic places in Night City today, as a symbol of corporate prowess. Its Goliath skyscrapers and mega buildings are an economic show of force and prestige for corporations such as Arasaka and Militech, as well as proof of their inferiority complex. Corpo Plaza's main attraction is Memorial Park, a huge ring surrounding the corporate headquarters. The park is also a tribute to the countless victims of the Fourth Corporate War. Every day, the plaza is teeming with everyone from Corpo suits to NCPD officers, and armed to the teeth, Corpo security. More than anything, an indication that peace and order are not among the Night City's natural qualities. Alright. Continuing with stuff. Oh, cool logo. Got more stuff. Tame Dragon, a biography of Yorinobu Arasaka. In many ways, the story of Yorinobu Arasaka resembles an ancient parable. The younger son of one of the modern world's most powerful CEOs renounces his heritage, forfeits his birthright, and instead chooses a rough-and-tumble life on the streets of Tokyo, only to later scamper back home to the warm, sheltered bosom of his family with his tail tucked. At least that is the story most have pieced together from official sources. But why did Yorinobu betray his father in the first place? Why did he return? For several years, I dug deeper, followed leads, reached out to his former friends and acquaintances. Slowly, I began to unearth answers to some of the public's most burning questions. Yorinobu was born in Tokyo in the early 21st century, the first child of Saburo Arasaka's third wife, Michiko. I think, by all accounts, he seemed a happy child that grew to become a pleasant young man, that is, until his graduation from the University of Tokyo at the age of 21. Following the ceremony, the Arasaka family threw a party in his honor. At some point in the evening, Saburo invited his son to his study for a private conversation. What transpired there is wholly unknown, but after corroborating varied accounts, it is clear Yorinobu must have slipped out from the party and the estate only a few hours later, gone, a whisper in the night. Over the next few years, Yorinobu was occasionally spotted in the company of a nomad group known as Kotetsu no Ryu, or the Steel Dragons. As part of this youthful rebellion, he purposely involved himself in altercations with Arasaka agents and promoted anti-corporate slogans. After his family eventually confirmed Yorinobu's involvement, Saburo renounced his son, and Kei, Saburo's eldest son, swore to exact revenge on his younger brother. Interesting. Ironically, it was later at Kei's funeral that Yorinobu at last reconciled with his father. Stubbornly proud to a fault, many were surprised by the Arasaka patriarch's conciliatory approach. What caused Saburo to change his mind? What role might have Yorinobu's sister, Hanako, played in their peaceable reunion? That much remains to be discovered. Mm-hmm. So these I can't interact with, I guess. That's blocked also.
Mr. Jenkins asked for you. He's in his office.
Which is that way. What's this way? Nothing.
Hey, V. It's been ages.
Frank, what's up?
It's me, Frank. We met during Icefall. East Coast, remember?
Frank. I remember you. Have you been?
I didn't know you were in Night City. Have you been?
You know how it is. A week ago, I was still in Cape Town. I heard you're in counter intel. Must have a shit show on your hands right now after Frankfurt.
Frankfurt.
Jenkins is your lead, right? Is he what everyone says he is?
He's gung-ho. What are people saying about Jenkins? Wait. Yeah, what are they saying about Jenkins?
What does everyone say about Jenkins?
That he's effective. Like any psychopath. Apparently, he's gone a little crazier lately.
Hey, he's in a tough spot. The director was supposed to greenlight his promotion when the Japanese arrived. She stabbed him in the back instead.
Oh, that does that. Yeah, that's no good. Tell me about Cape Town.
Tell me about the op in Cape Town.
Operation Cargo. You know about it?
Arming local conflicts in Africa. I didn't know that was you.
It was me. We dumped crates full of rifles into the ocean. They had to be pulled out using borrowed fishing boats.
Damn.
Same old circus, but hey, that's how wars are won.
Now, unfortunately, to move down, I remap my keys. I need to remap it to something else. Because now this goes to... You have to figure out what to do. Alright, who do you work under? Wait. This is kind of ridiculous, sorry. Who do you work under?
And you. Who do you work under?
Abernathy. She's really good. Came up with the whole Cape Town ploy on her own.
Abernathy?
Yeah.
The bitch who burned my boss on the promotion to Spec Ops Director.
You know how it is. Things happen.
Yeah.
They do indeed.
I need to run.
Listen, sorry. I'm in a bit of a rush right now. We'll talk another time, okay?
Sure, sure. Good seeing you again.
Likewise. Yeah, in order to change that, to remap that, I have to go back to the config file, so I can't even do that in-game here. What you got over there, huh?
Emergency protocols active. System security confirmed.
Well, no. Sorry. I'm not supposed to go in there, huh? Because it's red? Can I walk here?
3 dead.
Can I have coffee?
Bastard! He lobbied them hard for it when they flew in from Tokyo. Director of Special Operations? With his file?
The Japanese might buy it.
He said something else than what's printed there. So I can't walk in there. Huh. Cirrus Cola Corn and Lemon? Applies the hydration status, which increases max stamina by 10% and regen by 50% per second. Oh yeah, I'm taking everything that's not nailed down. Counterfeit documents?